Whether you're sold on some good old Costa del Sol, or maybe you're partial to a bit of Costa Blanca.
We love
Benidorm, woo! Woo-hoo, we do. There's one thing us Brits all agree on.
When the sun's shining, everybody's happy.
Too right, Carl. It's why many of us say bye-bye Blighty and hola, sunny Spain.
How could you not come here? It's paradise.
Living that life in the sun can come at a cost.
There is that pressure all the time to make sure you're earning the money.
It can be hard graft.
Hey, yeah, to you.
To me.
To you.
But when the working day is done...
This is what it's all about. Pool, barbecue, sunshine.
You might just make that fantasy a reality.
I feel like I'm a millionaire.
And that's why there will always be...
Sunshine.
Beaches.
The best life.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Today on the Costas, Lorna and Steve are racing to pack up their old home.
There's method in my madness with this.
Keep telling yourself that.
Yeah.
And move into their new one.
I'm just so done with this.
Tracy and Mike are pushing the boat out for their daughter's birthdays.
Why have I got no birthday?
And Clint takes a chance on a new career as a tour guide.
On the left-hand side is Ben Madden's Nature is Speech.
Buy more property in Spain than any other foreign nationals, making up 13% of the country's property market.
It's a beautiful country to live in. The people, the Spanish people, are just lovely. Food's cheaper, petrol's cheaper, alcohol's cheaper.
You had me sold at cheap food, Lorna, but it must come naturally when you sell statics in the sun for a living. The last time we saw Lorna, she had a caravan park full of plots to sell.
We've got some serious interest now, which is brilliant.
And she made her first sale.
Welcome. All day sunshine in your on your garden. You can do your nudie sunbathing there.
But she's not selling today.
Go on in. Back. Today's moving day.
Yes.
Yay.
Got to pack everything up.
Lorna's so confident in the homes she sells to other people, she and husband Steve have bought one for themselves.
We're doing it because I do the sales, but I don't drive. So to have me actually on site makes an awful lot of sense. And also I think it inspires a bit of confidence, the fact that the person selling is actually living on it physically.
The couple are saying goodbye to their current caravan and moving 5 minutes down the road to the new site.
Well, I've got some light stuff that can go in.
It's so near, they're not hiring any help.
We're really, really lucky in so much as we don't have to take any of the big stuff, no sofas, no beds, no nothing, because that's all included in the sale of the house, so it's just personal stuff.
She's now selling her own place. But she isn't managing the sale. This lady is. Hello?
Claire's going to be selling this place for us, so she's going to come round, have a look at it properly, because she does all the sales on here. She's got an idea because she's a friend of ours. She's been around a dozen times, but not with her salesperson head on. Hello.
Hello. You all right? Well, how weird is this?
Oh, more weird. Than a really weird thing. It feels very, very strange.
I am not here as your friend.
No.
I am here as your sales
rep. In a working capacity.
Very exciting.
Go on through.
Thank you.
You'll notice a lot missing.
Oh, gosh. Mm. Yes, you're packing.
As a property salesperson herself, Lorna knows a few tricks of the trade.
Right, what I've done, because this has got a load of add-ons mm-hmm. that weren't included in the normal spec.
Yeah.
I've printed them all off because I'll never remember what they are.
Oh, that's great. Perfect.
And then just a little help, a floor plan.
Oh, very nice. Well, that'll be good because...
Let's say they don't know what
they're
coming to look at.
I've not got anything to show them at the moment because it's not on the market
exactly.
yet.
Exactly. The house. 38 by 12, electric fire, aircon we had fitted.
Mm-hmm.
Patio doors. All the doors and windows have got mosquito nets in.
OK.
All of them. Mm. We're leaving the television and everything you see, apart from my rubbish, is included. Table, chairs, everything.
What about Steve? Is he included?
Need to get a move on, lovely, cos I've actually got somebody coming to view.
You've got somebody to come into... Yeah. I can't even say
calm.
It.
Calm. Nice and calm. Coming to view.
Already?
Well, I know it's not officially on the market, but...
It's not even close to being officially on the market.
Well, it's going to be very soon. You just have to say yes, Claire, and let me do my thing.
OK, yes, Claire. God, you're good.
It means Lorna and Steve have even less time to get their old home packed up and ready for Claire to show.
I've really got to get a move on now. There are no excuses. It's got to be all cleared, done, dusted, clean, sorted, like yesterday now. So it's... I don't know what to say. That's brilliant news. Really, really good, but a little bit... No pressure.
Think she's feeling the heat?
Oh, thank you, BB.
In Ben O'Madina, Clint Valentine is one of the hardest working expats of the Costas.
She's not just wanting to clean inside, I have to clean outside as well.
He puts in regular shifts at a horse sanctuary.
Sorted.
And has a job at a bar. I hope he's washed his hands.
More people means more money, more tips. There's not a single customer left less than €3 this morning.
You ready?
Clint's working his socks off and he's come up with another plan to earn some extra euros.
So today, this morning, before we start my work at the bar, we're going to go take all of our loyal customers that's been with us all week to meet us Pueblo on a coach trip.
Oh, I love a coach trip.
Yeah, you can. This is really just a test run to see how smoothly it goes. I wanted to work out the costings of what I would charge for tickets. We booked a 27-seater bus, but they've actually rang me back and said we're having a 55-seater.
That's a lot of seats to fill, Clint.
I'm confident that we'll have a nice group on the bus, whether it's full or whether it's not full. I didn't sleep very well last night, though.
Well, time to find out those numbers and get this show on the road.
Good morning, everybody.
No need for sleepless nights. Looks like a good turnout.
Today, you can look forward to a nice informative guide along the coast and then up onto Mijas Pueblo, which is the famous little white village here on the Costa del Sol. It is one of my favourite places to visit. Whenever I bring guests from the UK, it's one place we always go to, and I've never had a bad result yet. Everyone really loves Mijas Pueblo. If you want to start making your way down onto the bush, feel free. The quicker we're on, the quicker we can get set off, really, so...
Already taking charge. I reckon you're a natural, Clint.
My last two stragglers now. Come on, on you get.
There's always one. Well, in this case, there's two. And we're off.
Now, here on the right-hand side, you've got the flagship hotel. I think the reason it's popular is because of the views from the balcony. Because there on the left-hand side, hidden by all those apartments, is Ben O'Madina's naturist beach, Benal Natura. So looking from the balconies, you may get more than you wished to see. I see you all now breaking your necks to look out the left-hand side and not the right-hand side, so that tells me what sort of customers I've got on the bus today.
What was the name of that hotel? Sorry, Clint, you carry on.
Columbus Castle is the smallest wedding chapel in the world. You can only take four people into the castle. So there's only the two people getting married, one witness and the vicar.
Ooh, that sounds cosy, and more importantly, cheap.
Now, Torre Quebrada is also home of a very famous man, and the Banderas name is still very popular around here. So even if they're not related to Antonio Banderas, if you ask anybody around here with a Banderas name, a lot of them will still claim that they are related to him. Yay, we're here! Right, are we all ready? Follow me, first of all, to the zebra crossing. I don't want to get any of you run over.
Good plan. Don't want to get negative reviews on your first trip. Coming up, joke shop owner Matt throws a bash to raise cash.
I'm hoping to raise a lot of money, basically.
And Tracy and Mike show that size doesn't matter.
It's tiny. You can go and get out now.
Many Brits dream of moving to sunnier climes, and a lucky few make that dream a reality. One of them is Roger James from Gloucestershire.
Hello, I'm Roger. Come on in. Welcome to my home in Spain.
Well, thanks, Rog. But unlike those who moved here for the weather or cheaper way of life, Roger joined the Spanish club for a different reason.
My main hobby is playing golf. Various golf trophies and bits and pieces from over the years. Club captain in 2015.
Congratulations.
Cabinet for the trophies over there.
Impressive.
This is the thing about Spain. This golf course is absolutely everywhere. You're absolutely sport for choice. You're just not going to get round them all. you know, it's an impossibility.
I'm sure you'll give it a good try.
I've played golf for, more years than I can remember. And at one stage, I was quite good at it, including the hole in one.
You clever birdie, Roger. I always find that hole with the windmill really hard. Right, Rog, let's tee off on a tour of your home.
Well, this is the living room. As you can see, that was a bargain, that settee. I got that from a local shop down the village. Half price. Very nice. Oh, and learning Spanish. I think this is for 8-year-olds, but we're trying. I have lessons every Friday morning. I think you need to try and learn Spanish. You know, you need to fit in. You can't just use English. I know a lot of people just use English and won't learn, but I think you need to integrate more, don't you?
Muy bien, Roger. Very good.
Well, there's not really much to say about the kitchen. It's a kitchen.
Well, you're not wrong.
I'm a dab hand in the kitchen, yeah. I do, pretty much anything. I can read a book with recipes. Spanish dishes are going to be the thing, I think, because there's some beautiful, beautiful Spanish food. And I don't understand Brits come into Spain and go in, I can only eat English. You've got to integrate, haven't you? You've got to eat the Spanish.
I'm not sure we're here to eat the Spanish, Roger.
Most of the bits and pieces in the fridge are Spanish.
Thankfully, I can't see any locals in there, so I think we're all right.
And this is the main bedroom. Nice big bed. Little bit of a view. This is a new-ish aircon. That's probably 18 months old. And that one's got all the bits and pieces on. The sleep moulds and all sorts on that one. Quite a fandangled thing.
Everyone needs a fandangled thing.
So that was my home in Spain. Thank you very much for coming. And have a pleasant day.
Well, you too, Roger. And thank you for having us.
Let's finish off this room, then.
On the Costa del Sol.
Mind if it's on that?
It's moving day for Lorna and Steve, who've just found out they have a viewing in only a couple of days' time.
We have got the most ridiculous day. Bearing in mind, we've got to do everything. We've got to pack. We've got to clean everything. Are you fine? You just stand there and watch. That's no problem whatsoever.
After 6 years in their home, their belongings need boxing up in a matter of hours.
I don't think it makes any difference whether you're moving 40,000 miles or 4 minutes up the road. It's still the same theory. You've got to pack everything, move everything, get it there.
I don't think you actually mean pack everything.
That can stay here, because that is...
We're packing, not leaving everything behind.
Whoever buys it might use that.
Nothing like a free plug socket to attract potential buyers.
In here is our memory box that occasionally we have to go through because we forget what the memories are. But it's all cards that Steve and I have sent each other over the years. I mean, literally everything. Steve is my husband for the last 18 years. He's the current Mr. Lorna. Until he pulls his socks up, and he's doing all right at the minute.
And they say romance is dead.
Look at this, my wedding dress.
And you still look gorgeous in it.
Bless, I don't fit in it, I don't think.
I bet you would.
Not sure about that. Right, I haven't got time for this. We'll be here all day doing this otherwise. Don't throw that away. Get away.
Throw it away.
It's this.
Being useful.
You think?
Well.
They say moving house is one of the most stressful things you can do, but I find popping bubble wrap really helps ease the tension.
I've run out of bubble wrap now.
Oh, no.
I've lost the scissors as well. Have you let me spoon took the scissors?
Yeah, I just picked them up off the floor because I got bare feet.
Yeah, but it's all good, honestly. It's piling bubble wrap. I know where they are, then. There's method in my madness with this.
Keep telling yourself that.
Yep.
With just the smaller items to pack, Lorna and Steve make light work of the living room.
OK, now we're getting somewhere.
Shift this into kitchen.
OK, so we should Have a look at the spare room, then. We're all afraid.
Well, if it's anything like my spare room, it'll be full of all sorts of random stuff.
What? What are you laughing at? It's my scarecrow outfit. For Halloween.
Bin.
OK.
Moving just a few minutes up the road means Lorna and Steve will have to do a few trips in their hatchback, and that needs some careful planning.
OK, boxes. We're not going to get much more than this in the car. So by the time we've got all these boxes, that picture...
Well, should we start filling the car and then we see what else we can just ram into it? Oh, the joys of moving yourself and not using a removal company.
Correct.
Not recommended.
As Lorna and Steve continue the mission to move into their new place, in Los Boliches, a couple of old friends have already settled into their new pad.
Hi, welcome back. I'm Tracy.
Tracy and Mike run a sports bar and a tapas restaurant, both of which were hit hard by the lack of tourists during Spain's lockdown.
Since we last saw you, things have picked up. Some days we have our off days, some days we have our good days.
Both businesses mean working late, so the couple decided to make a big change.
We have moved house. We now live closest to the bar, so we save 40 minutes a day on travelling, don't we?
Sounds ideal.
The apartment? No. You can't swing a cap round it, but the location is brilliant.
Fair enough. Let's have a look around, then.
This is the extra tiny bathroom. You can't get by because of the bidet. And the shower I can't make friends with at all. Every time you turn the shower on and you stand in the shower, it turns itself off.
Ah, nothing like a relaxing shower. And that sounds nothing like a relaxing shower.
As you can see, it's tiny. You can't turn around, because if you turn around, you turn that off with either your boobs or your bums. You can't win. And then when you close the door, it's just too claustrophobic. Go and get out now.
Well, at least you can see the funny side, Tracy.
This is Mike's stock room, where he sits here and he plays grumpy. There's not much space to get by here. This is what we have to deal with. Just enough room to get through.
Moving from a house to a flat means that floor space isn't the only thing the couple have compromised on.
And we've gone now from a king-size bed to a double bed, which doesn't make it easier. Because Mike can't fit in it.
No, feet overhang.
And then when I go to the toilet at night, look, I have to move it. Don't see it moving.
Maybe swap sides of the bed. Just a suggestion. On with the tour.
This is the living room, and this is the two daughters. This is Danielle.
Hiya.
Hi.
And this is Liam.
Hi, how are you?
Hi.
I think they've got the giggles.
It's the best way to be.
We have at the moment both daughters over. The last time they was both out here together would have been pre-COVID 2019.
And they're over for the birthdays.
And the birthdays, yeah.
I'd better get me party clothes on.
Our plans today is we're having the girls over. We're going to go and have some fun and we'll enjoy ourselves, especially with it being pre-birthdays.
Shh, with the girls listening, Tracy can't say that she's planning a surprise. Mum's the word, Tracy, literally. It's mid-morning.
You will get a chance to look at the markets later.
And just 8 kilometres away...
Now, the church from the 15th century I told you about, it's over about down in that corner. You can just see the tops of it there.
In the village of Mijas, Clint Valentine is running a coach trip for the regulars at the bar where he works.
I would say the biggest worry today was that nobody was going to arrive for the bus, and luckily we had a big, massive group of people. So I would say that's been a roaring success up to now.
Now, you've just got to keep those customers sweet, Clint.
Come with me now, Chocolate Factory.
That should do it.
We're going to go now have a look around inside the chocolate factory, and I'm today going to make myself some chocolate as well. It's like Willy Wonka's chocolate factory.
I hope not. That place was a health and safety nightmare.
So the way we use the ingredients is we just take the pot, put a little bit on our hand, and then from our hand decorate, OK? I've got coconut. Anybody for some coconut?
The banana, the dried banana I'd like.
Anybody for cashew?
Yeah, I'll have some of them on there as well. I think that might be our lot, though. We can't fit any more on.
Actually, it is like Willy Wonka's place. Every flavour you can imagine.
I'm going to make one of everything today. Dark, milk, and light chocolate, all of them. Look delicious. I could like to dip my head in that.
Before the chocolate sets, Clint needs to add his flavourings.
I've got ginger, I've got hazelnuts, I've got goji berries. I am a connoisseur.
So now it's on the Ray Oompa Loompas. You get to use the Oompa Loompa door.
Told you. Come on, she won't even need to bob down, look, she's that little.
Thankfully for Clint, unlike the film about the chocolate factory, everyone has emerged unscathed. So what's next?
Everyone's got a couple of hours to go and walk around and enjoy Mijas Pueblo. And there's a couple of girls that don't really know what to do around here, and I found them quite good fun, so I'm going to take them around now, and we're going to do a bit of sightseeing. I'm going to go show them around and give them a little mini tour.
It's the VIP treatment for Anne and Leanne.
It's gorgeous, isn't it? When you see it from up here. So, it's not a clear day today, obviously, but if you look that way, normally you can see Morocco.
We'll have to take your word for it, but hopefully the sketchy weather won't put a dampener on the trip.
That's a misty day today, so you won't see any of that.
We're taking a quick trip 483 kilometres along the coast to Benidorm, where joke shop owner Matt Kirkland has welcomed us back.
Two tools of €4, it's a little joke I like to do.
The last time we saw Matt, travel restrictions meant business was no laughing matter.
If things don't pick up, we are going to have to move back, because basically I can earn more money over there. We don't want to go back to the UK.
Look at that beach. I don't blame you, Matt. Especially now the holidaymakers are back. Hello, mate.
I-ho, I-ho, it's off to Benidorm we go.
The last 10 months have made a huge difference for Matt, and business is improving.
Comedy costumes for blokes, surgeon, gangster, dad's army. It started picking up again March time, and then we had a good Easter.
I'm glad things have picked up. And with the shop's books all balanced, Matt's now helping to raise money for others.
The charity, what we've been involved with for the Ukraine war efforts, we're going to buy things what are necessary, you know, for the families.
Later today, Matt and his mate Bert are throwing a fundraising party in the village of Reu, where they live.
It was just a friend of mine, he just had this idea, and everybody's helped. Or, you know, there's been a lot of people involved with helping. This is why it, you know, it's going to be successful, because of the community there. But there's only 1,400 people, I believe, what's in the village. There's even Ukraine people living in the village who on the same road as me. I'm hoping to raise a lot of money, basically.
They say charity begins at home, or in this case, the home of good friend Bert, who's hosting today's party.
I met Matt and I told him about the Ukraine festival that we were planning. And he said, can I help you? Can I support you? And he has been great.
Hey, Bert, how's it going?
How are you doing?
Yeah, how's it going?
Yeah, oh, fantastic. Really going great.
As well as loaning out his garden for the event, Bert's also been busy selling tickets.
Ticket sales?
Two excellent ticket sales. We've sold everything except four.
180?
Yeah.
Wow, that is good, that.
Really good.
180 people? I hope Bert's got a big enough garden. Coming up, it's all aboard for Tracy and Mike's birthday day out. And joke shop owner Matt puts the fun into fundraiser.
Tonight, Matthew, you're going to be Willie Nelson.
It's early afternoon on the Costa del Sol, where Lorna and Steve have arrived to move into their new home.
Steve,
open up, move the boxes. I don't know what we're going to put on it.
Oh, I just put everything away for the time being and I can sort it all out when...
Tomorrow.
Manana, that never comes. I say, in 6 months' time, we'd be out. I really should sort that cupboard out.
Yep.
This move has been 6 months in the planning and it's finally a reality.
I cannot believe we're actually finally doing it. You know when you're waiting for something for, like, forever?
Yep.
And now we're doing it.
We are. It's here.
It's brilliant.
It sure is. But when it comes to moving, Lorna and Steve are old hands.
Moved to Spain around about, well, practically to the day, 20 years ago. Well, I actually moved to Tenerife. Spent 12 years over there. It's a lovely, lovely island, but it's, you get a bit stir-crazy because it is so small. So we came to mainland Spain. We looked for something that we could move in instantly, and so we came to Caravan Park, and it's suited us down to the ground ever since.
Shouldn't that be on a shelf? Oh, shut up, shall I?
And I'm not a great one for change, believe it or not. It's my third move since I've moved on to this park.
Well, this should be a doddle, then.
So where's your flat vase going?
A flat vase? It's a bowl. Is that a flat vase?
Because it's short and stumpy.
Actually, Steve, I think you've got a point.
Done.
Not quite, Lorna. You've still got half your old caravan to pack up.
We've got two boxes unpacked. Yay! Round two.
Round two.
In the village of Mijas, in the mountains above Benalmádena, Clint's coach trip is coming to an end.
This one ours?
He's hoping to run tours like this to make some extra cash in the winter, when the days aren't too chilly and folks will still enjoy being out and about.
You all enjoyed your morning? Mijas Pueblo is lovely, isn't it?
With everyone back on board, we're heading home.
I just checked that the microphone.
Do it, do it. Give it a whack.
Do it, do it. OK.
That's it. And a working mic can only mean one thing. More of Clint's encyclopedic knowledge of the area to entertain his guests.
Most of the people that live in Benalmádena, in Mijas Pueblo, were trained in agriculture. Generally, they grow now mainly olive trees up in the mountains. We actually supply 76% of the world's olive oil.
Branching out with your facts, eh, Clint?
Do you want to know a fun fact about those orange trees, what you see all dotted around Spain? They actually made it against the law to pick those oranges. If you picked those oranges and took a bag full home, you've broken the law and you've risked a €500 fine.
Oof, that's one expensive orange.
Almost, you know.
And hopefully dropping off a coach full of satisfied customers.
If you have enjoyed your day today, if you did want to leave myself or Paco, the driver, a tip today, we will leave a box at the front. I am also saving for a new caravan.
In the future, Clint would like to charge €10 per seat for his coach trips. And today's trial run has gone well with the locals.
Do you have a box? Premium box? Premium box? If you want to leave a tip, you can just leave it on the front there.
I think they've got the hint, Clint.
There are one.
A lovely, lovely day out, relaxing.
Oh, it looks like the reviews are already coming in.
Thank you. It's just been a wonderful day. Clint, today,
thank you.
He's done brilliant. Thank you. Oh, there was loads, wasn't there? Thank you. Is everybody off?
But now to see if the nice words translate into cold, hard cash.
Okay. Muy bien. Oh, gracias. Buen día. I got €101 in tips today. That'll go towards my caravan. Bit by bit, I'm getting there. I would say today was a roaring success.
Me too, Clint. Me too. As an island nation, we Brits have always had a special bond with the sea. And even when we're on holiday, we love to take to the waves.
We are going out on a speedboat. You can sit on the boat. I'll go on the rubber ring or the dinghy or the bloody banana boat, whatever it is.
Been on banana boats. Been on banana boats before. They're great fun. Been on pedalos. Yeah, they're great. Yeah, all great fun.
I'm hoping to try and get on jet skiing.
Yeah, I would definitely go on a jet ski. Yeah.
Never done it, but yeah, definitely. Try it.
And what about you two ladies?
We have been watching the jet skiing activity, which looks really cool.
I'm not doing it, though. Don't want to ruin my eyelashes.
Sounds like the perfect time to launch my patented jet ski-proof eyelashes. In Fuengirola, and hoping for an eyelash incident-free day by the sea, Tracy and Mike have organised a birthday surprise for daughters Danielle and Leanne.
They think that we're going to Bella Madonna. They're actually going on jet skis. They don't know nothing about it. I wanted to make this trip extra special because, one, Danielle missed out on her 21st because of the pandemic. So this is sort of her 21st, but it's also Leanne's 30th. So obviously it's a joint birthday for the both to sort of have a good time and enjoy being here.
The jet ski company are going to let Tracy know when everything is ready so she can make the girls' trip from England even more special.
We don't need these ones. You know what? I'm absolutely thrilled that you're both here. It's going to be an exciting day. We're going on the ferry, which is something we have never done.
To keep her surprise under wraps, Tracy's told Leanne and Danielle that they're getting the ferry to Ben O'Madina, which is a brilliant plan.
We've got 10 minutes.
For what?
To ferry. Ferry.
Is that our ferry, though? There it is. We're going quick, quick.
Is it?
Yeah.
A brilliant plan, unless the ferry they're not actually catching arrives early.
Getting a bit paranoid now because the ferry's here and the kids think we're going on the ferry, but the guys that are taking on the jet ski aren't here, so we need to get the people here now. Oh, come on.
With no news from the jet ski people, Tracy's surprise is in danger of falling apart.
She's on her way. She's on her way now.
Thank God for that. It's all going to plan.
Phew. I don't think my nerves could have taken much more. Now to tell the girls.
You didn't get the jet skis on your birthday, but it was easy to get you both a jet ski.
I'm loving it, Mum. Thank you.
Now, do you know why I told you to put your swimming stuff on?
I didn't think it was going to succeed, to be fair, but it worked out well.
After a bit of instruction, it's time to take to the water like a graceful swan.
Why have I got no breath?
We've just gone out. Danielle's a bit, I don't even know how to express what she was a bit, to be fair. She was a bit nervous, but I think she'll be all right.
I'm sure she'll be fine. Here they come, back to port. Let's see how it went.
Best experience of my life. It's so far. As far as it falls.
How was that, Danielle?
I'm very wet.
Well, they say worst things happen at sea.
Yeah, my eyelashes flew off.
It's obviously a common nautical mishap, but missing eyelashes aside, I wonder if Tracy's surprise was a success.
I didn't expect my mum to surprise me with a jet ski. Like, I'm so grateful for it. The experience is amazing.
It's absolutely awful. My eyelashes blew off. Like, fully. Just went. I'm gone. 100%, I'd do it again. It was great.
Thank goodness. I'm glad you enjoyed it, because there's more to come.
We've got another surprise, which they don't know about. We're going to go on a party boat for a two-hour trip. It makes me happy knowing that I've given them something that they want to do.
The village of Rayu, 6 hours' drive away from Tracy and Mike, is usually a quiet and peaceful place. But not today. The residents have turned out for a charity party organised by pals Bert and joke shop owner Matt.
This is the main area where it's all happening. We have the pool, no one's been in swimming yet. I'm sure we won't before the day's done. I'm sure it will. Matt has supplied all the hats and fancy dress for people, and it's been fantastic. The mayor is over here, and it's been great because the mayor's here. We haven't had any problems with licensing or anything like that. If anybody wants to come and get a drink, everything you pay is what you make great.
It's not what you know, eh, Bert? And all in the name of a good cause.
Alina. Hola, hola. Bien? Bien?
Never want to miss an opportunity. Matt says hello to the mayor. Even dignitaries might need to buy the occasional whoopee cushion.
Saying
thanks to everybody.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Yeah. Thank you for coming.
The local mayor isn't the only guest of honour. Oleg and Victoria are from Ukraine and have lived in the village for 4 years.
Today we have a very big Ukrainian-style party, and many English people from this region was coming here to help Ukrainian to fight this war. We have a mixed community, and all community protect us here.
And it's time for the community to party.
Tonight, Matthew, you're going to be Willie Nelson. That's the wig to put under your hat.
And just like that, it's time for Bert's moment in the spotlight. I say spotlight, I mean blazing sunshine.
This was Willie Nelson's biggest hit, believe it or not. Just can't wait to get on the road again. My fine love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
Do you know, I've not heard him sing before. He's really good.
Yeah. Mr. Cameron James!
Well, thank you, smiling face has said it all, and hopefully we'll have raised a lot of money.
It's been an enjoyable day for everyone here. Back at the shop, Matt's been adding up how much the event has raised.
The charity has raised £4,800, and that's just for, you know, the people of the village.
Wow. It's an impressive amount that will make a big difference. Well done to the party people of Reyu. Coming up, Tracy and Mike's birthday celebrations cause a splash.
One, two, three, four!
And as Lorna and Steve's move draws to a close...
Really, what? Put them in the drawer. Do I just leave them on the side?
Lorna's drawers get in a twist.
Button three.
I haven't been given permission for drawers.
It's late afternoon on the Costa del Sol and it's still baking hot.
It's boiling.
It's too bloody hot.
I'll tell you about the weather. It's too bloody hot.
Bearable. Just barely. Suffering, as you can see here.
That's why we wear bucket hats, because we're sensible.
Smart people. Sun cream on the face.
I'm like a cricketer.
In Fuengirola, Tracy and Mike have planned the perfect way to cool down. Another birthday surprise for daughters Danielle and Liam.
Did you go Bella Magna?
Ching, ching.
Come on, then.
Earlier, the girls went jet skiing and they're heading back out to sea for their next treat.
You've actually got a yacht!
Don't be so impressed, Leanne. In Spain, hiring a yacht is pretty easy.
Come on, time, girl!
Getting aboard, however, not so easy. With everyone now safely on board, they can all enjoy living the high life.
Now everybody's come along with us now to enjoy a surprise for the kids. It's a shame Danielle fell in, but never mind.
I feel like I'm a millionaire.
I just
got
done it!
One, two, three!
It's been a busy day for the family, but like all good things, it's come to an end. But I reckon Tracy's surprise will last a lifetime.
It has been a massive surprise. Like, none of us actually realised that it was going to happen.
I've really appreciated what she's done. This has been amazing for me. Today has been probably the best day of my life.
An hour inland and moving day is almost over for Lorna and Steve, who are nearly done packing up their old home.
We did it.
We did. Been a very good little house, though.
It's been a fab little house. We've had some nice times. We've got good memories.
Yes.
Which is nice, but we'll make some more bitterer ones.
We will.
In the
onwards
new...
Onwards and upwards.
Onwards and upwards, indeed. Yes.
Come on, it.
Like a lot of people, they've left the essentials until last, you know, things like tea bags and all the ingredients needed to knock up at a last-minute Indian banquet.
Spice rack. I'll just put them all in a bag and they can go in.
Yeah. And with that, it's time to leave their home for the final time.
That's it.
Bye-bye, Hank. Right.
It's been a race against the clock to get everything out in time for their first viewing in a couple of days, but they did it. Job done.
Oh, it's warm. 39 degrees.
Yep.
And I thought moving in the UK was hard enough.
Nearly there. One more box to go. Oh, the last box.
That's Henry.
You want this carpet?
Oh, yeah. That's
right. Nothing like a bit of teamwork to make a tough job less stressful. Or is that more stressful?
I'm just so done with this. I really am. I'm really... Why don't I put them in a drawer? Do I just leave them on the side?
I don't know. There was a loading of them drawers.
Bottom three.
I haven't been given permission for drawers.
Bottom three are yours. Oh, it's just stress, isn't it? It's just so much ag. But it's got to be done.
Thankfully, the hard work is behind them.
Everything's been moved. It's been the day from hell. It's been so, so long. And we're both totaled, but we're in.
And no sooner are they in...
Oh.
They're back out to enjoy their new garden.
Oh.
Lovely sound. Cheers.
Hello.
To the new house.
To the new house.
Ah, Casa, sweet Casa. Congratulations.
It's a very pleasant breeze.
Oh, it's lovely.
Next time on The Costas, Colin's welcoming a new guest to his rescue centre.
I am excited. It's kind of like a kid at Christmas. I'm getting a new thing. Who doesn't like a new phone?
We're in for a bumpy ride with cousins John and Jamie.
I can see them, Shaq.
And it's eyes on the prizes at Jade's boot camp.
It gives me an absolute great pleasure to award the winner of the biggest battler to...
Coming up after the break, the Prime Minister promises to get Britain moving in her first speech to the party.
And diamonds are forever. Find out how Dame Shirley Bassey celebrated 60 years of Bond songs. Join us at 5.